Bring things back home now. Kite surfing makes a welcome return to the shores of Cape Town. Participants from all over the world are in town to be the king of the air. The competition is wind dependent, with forecasts predicting ideal conditions this weekend. ENCA's Justin Ford has more.
The Red Bull King of the Air has been a well-attended event over the years. This year will be different due to the COVID-19 pandemic, but local kite surfer Josh Emmanuel is excited to be competing. He explains the gear required to ride the waves.
For me, obviously, choice of kites. Obviously, you got different models and stuff in the ranges. My choice of kite is the GTS and the Nexus. Behind us, we have the Nexus, which is my bigger kite that I would ride if I needed to. Otherwise, in my smaller sizes, I use the GTS, which is quite a powerful, explosive kite, which is, again, fully my style of riding.
Kevin Langery is a past winner of the competition.
I'm definitely going for the win. Otherwise, I'm not going to compete. I want to win. I'm going to try my ultimate best. I know there's a lot of guys very hungry for that number one position, but I think, I've put a lot of time in my training, not only on the water, but also off the water.
Britain's Tom Bridge is here to enjoy the event and is lifting the pressure of expectation off his shoulders.
I don't think there's any pressure on us younger crew, because we're coming up, we've got nothing to prove. Whereas if I was one of the older guys and one of the more established riders, then I'd feel a lot more pressure.
Emmanuel hopes to turn in a strong performance despite the stiff competition.
Hopefully, I think I stand a good chance. It's been a long year for me. Obviously, I had an ACL reconstruction surgery in February, which is about a 9 month to full recovery, which is almost, to date right now. So in terms of physical training on the water, it hasn't been a huge lot this year for me.
Competitors expect the event to begin by Saturday. Justin Ford, Cape Town.